Now, in my mind, there are two major separate halves to adjusting color, no matter what software you're using: color correction and color grading. Color correction is the first step in the process, and that entails adjusting each individual shot so that it has correct exposure, the correct white balance and color temperature, and making sure that each shot has a good looking saturation as well. And then we move on to the color grading process. This is the part of the process where you will take an overall adjustment layer and add it over top of all of the corrected shots in your project and add creative visual flair that creates a cohesive look throughout the project. This is oftentimes where people will add LUTs to the project as well. Before we head over to the computer and get started on this project, if you would like to follow along, I've actually added a link in the description below and in the comments section of this video where you can download all of the shots that I will be using and adjusting in this video and a free LUT to try out as well. So just click that link, head over and get the shots, and then when you're ready, we'll get started. Okay guys, here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2022. You'll see I have my color workspace pulled up. I have three separate shots pulled up and placed back to back on my timeline: a wide shot, a medium shot, and a close up. You can download these video clips to follow along using the link in the video description. These video files are shot in a flat profile for reference. Shooting in a flat or log profile is a bit more difficult to color correct and grade in post, but it offers us the most flexibility when adjusting the images, because there is more information and more dynamic range to work with. The first thing we should do is go over the color workspace in Adobe Premiere and learn about the interface and the tools we will be using. This is the default color workspace in Adobe Premiere 2022, and I'll go over the notable changes when you select this workspace. In the top left, we have the scopes window. To the right of that, we have the program window. And to the right of that, we have the Lumetri color panel. I would recommend altering this default workspace a bit by clicking the wrench at the bottom of the Lumetri scopes window. Click on Presets and then select Vector Scope, YUV, Parade RGB, and Waveform YC. I would also select the wrench again, choose Waveform Type, and select Luma. This will pull up the set of scopes that I usually use to color correct and color grade. Learning how to read these scopes is one of the most beneficial things you can do if you are wanting to learn how to color correct and color grade your own footage. And I highly recommend that you study these scopes beyond the scope of this video to learn as much as possible. The waveform is going to help us read and correct exposure in the image. The RGB parade is going to help us correct white balance in the image, and this helps to see the balance of color in the image, whether it may be too warm or too cool. The higher the color is reading on the scope, the more dominant it is in the image. The final scope we're looking at is the vector scope, and it's basically a scope that demonstrates how the images we are working with correspond to the color wheel. The white, wispy color in the center of the wheel represents our image, showing us the colors that are in the image and how saturated they are. The further the white trace is from the center of the scope, the more dominant and saturated the color is in the image, depending on what color the trace is pointing to. We will also be using the Lumetri color panel. This is where we can actually adjust our image using the various tools and sliders. Now that we know the tools we are working with, let's get started color correcting these images. The first thing we want to do is correct the exposure of the image. The first thing that I usually do to correct exposure in an image is to lower the blacks slider in the basic correction tab on the Lumetri panel. Pay attention to the waveform scope and notice how the lowest parts of the wave move closer to the bottom as you lower the black slider. We want the bottom part of the waveform to sit just above zero on the waveform scale. Now let's bring up the highlights by increasing the slider on the whites within the basic correction tab. Increase the slider until the upper parts of the waveform sit just below 100 on the waveform scope. Now let's lower the shadows a bit to bring the image to life and get rid of any washed out looks. Now we will adjust the white balance if needed within the image. Depending on the image you are color correcting, your image may look too warm or too cool. Using the RGB scope for reference, we can get an idea of the color balance within this image. White balance and color temperature can be manually done, or you can let Premiere do it for you automatically. I like to let Premiere do it for me. Just select the eyedropper tool in the white balance selector section in the Lumetri window and select something within the image that is white. You'll see that the temperature and the tint sliders are automatically adjusted, and the forms within the RGB parade should be more closely aligned. Lastly, we will boost the saturation of the image by sliding the saturation slider in the Lumetri panel to the right until it looks good. Don't overdo it here. If, for some reason, things don't look right to you at this point, you can still tweak any of these sliders a bit until the waveforms are closer to the values I mentioned earlier, or if the image just looks good to your eye. Just try to make it look as balanced as possible, without anything on your scopes going below 0 or above 100. Make sure the image isn't washed out and you don't have blown out highlights or data loss in the shadows if you can avoid it. Sometimes, depending on the shot you're working with, you may have to do the best with what you have. Once you have a look that you like and you want to copy the results to other shots on your timeline, just select the clip you like on your timeline, hit Command-C on a Mac or Control-C on a PC to copy the adjustments. Then right-click on the clip you want to copy to and choose Paste Attributes. A box will pop up. Make sure the Lumetri checkbox is selected and click OK. It's that simple. If any of the clips on your timeline don't match close enough and you want to get them closer to one another, just pull up the comparison view under the Color Wheels and Match tab in the Lumetri window. This will display a side-by-side comparison of two shots on your timeline. You can pick different views for this as well. You'll notice that our scopes are displaying a comparison in their windows as well. Just select the time reference position for the clip on the left. This will be the clip that we are trying to match to, and use the sliders and tools in the Lumetri panel to adjust the clip on the right to better match the clip and its waveforms on the left. Premiere can also do this function for us as well automatically, but I would recommend not using it as it doesn't work too well. When you're finished, just disable the comparison view by clicking the button again in the tab, and let's get started on our color grading half of the process. Now for this half of the process, we are going to apply adjustments over top of all of the images on our timeline to give them a cohesive look. We do this by creating an adjustment layer and positioning it above the video clips on our timeline. Just go to the project window, located in the bottom left of our workspace. Click the little piece of folded edge paper icon, which is the new item button, and select adjustment layer. A window will pop up. Now select OK. The adjustment layer will now show up in our project bin. Now just drag and drop the adjustment layer over to your timeline and drop it on a video layer above your video clips. This adjustment layer will affect everything that sits below it on the timeline. Make sure to drag out the length of your adjustment layer on the timeline so that it lasts for the duration of your clips and matches up with them. We can manually affect our adjustment layer using the Lumetri tab and create our own overall look for the project, or we can apply a LUT in the Creative tab and tweak it a bit to our liking. I usually prefer to save time and work with a LUT that comes close to the look and feel of what I'm going for, and then use the intensity slider to bring it up or down depending on how it looks over the top of the images. So, let's go to the Creative tab within the Lumetri panel. Here we can browse our system for a specific look, or we can cycle through the LUTs that are installed on our system quickly using the arrows here to see what they look like before applying. I'll go to the Look drop-down here and select the free LUT that I've created for this tutorial, which you can find the link for in the video description below. This link will take you to my digital store where there are other LUT packs you can pick up to help support the channel, and there's also some other free resources there as well, so be sure to check it out. Once I find my LUT using the Browse tool, you'll see that the LUT is applied to our adjustment layer and it's affecting all of the clips on our timeline that are below it. If it looks too overbearing or not strong enough, we can adjust the intensity slider to bring it up or down. And since we've matched our clips earlier, they should still all look pretty similar to one another. But if one or two clips in particular aren't looking up to snuff, or they aren't matching the others as intended, we can go back in and affect the individual clips themselves and tweak them like we did earlier, affecting the original color correction and seeing how it looks now with the color grade applied. And that's pretty much my process. And there you have it, guys. I know we covered a ton of information in this video, but I hope that it was easy to follow along and you learned something, you found it beneficial, and I hope it makes a big difference in any of your future projects as well. If you've watched the video this long, first off, thank you so much. And do me a big favor and post the word colorist in the comments section below, along with any questions or comments that you might have, so I can tell who my best viewers are. This free content is brought to you in part by our amazing channel members. If you would like to become a channel member yourself and gain access to early videos, name shoutouts, exclusive emojis, and behind the scenes content, and much, much more, please just click the join button on the channel header above. Thanks so much for coming along on this filmmaking journey with me. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.